About midway between Lisbon and Fatima is the little village of Santarém. In the year 1147, the first king of Portugal, Afonso Henriques, recaptured the city from the Moors by having his men scale the city walls with ladders and then open the gates. Exactly 1 year later, the Son of God captured the city for himself when he saw fit to allow a Eucharistic miracle to take place to avoid a great evil.
Sanctus, Sanctus, Sanctus.
This is the Igreja de Santissimo Milagre, the Church of the Holy Miracle. Along the sides are paintings that tell the story of how the miracle came about. On February 16, 1247, a woman, convinced that her husband was cheating on her, took a consecrated host from the Church of St. Stephen, intending to give it to a witch the next day so she could create a love potion. As soon as the woman wrapped the Blessed Sacrament in a handkerchief, it began to bleed. She hid it in a chest and went to sleep. That night, rays of light poured from the chest, making the room as bright as day. The woman's husband saw it and demanded his wife tell him what was going on. The next day, the parish priest retrieved the host with a solemn procession. The host continued to bleed for 3 days afterwards. So what is a Eucharistic miracle, you might be asking? Catholics believe, have always believed, that the bread and wine we eat during the Mass becomes the body and blood of Jesus Christ at the moment of consecration. Sometimes, God deigns to remove the veil from our eyes, and a Eucharistic miracle occurs. What looks like bread suddenly looks like and is actual human flesh, bleeding actual human blood. Eucharistic miracles dot the globe. Fortunately for pilgrims to Portugal, this one is easily accessible.